On every bottle of medication, it will explain how often you can safely take it, but not very many give instructions on how long you can stay on the medication until you're at risk of adverse side effects. But both time periods are important, and for some medications, they are critical. Consider someone who has to take medication every day. The medicine isn't completely eliminated from the body before the next dose is taken, and there would be even more left in the blood by the third, fourth, fifth dose. And yet, there are many people who do take medicines every single day, so why aren't they all dropping like flies from toxic blood concentration levels? These are important questions in the field of pharmacokinetics, and the key to understanding what's going on is series. In this video, we'll do a little math to understand how someone can be on a daily medication for decades and still not have to worry about blood concentration toxicity. Do not take anything in this video as medical advice and always consult with a medical professional if you have questions about your medications. It is true that I'm a doctor, just not the kind that can help people medically. In our last video, we used a common math model of medicinal blood concentration to adjust my sleep medication dosage. That model works well for pills, which take time for your body to absorb. We will use that model later on in the video, but to start off, let's start with a simpler situation, when being given medications directly into the bloodstream via an IV. This allows us to model the blood concentration with immediate absorption, and then just focus on how the body eliminates the drug from the blood. One way doctors and pharmacists talk about how fast blood is eliminated from the body is through the idea of half-life. The half-life of a drug is the time it takes your body to take half the medicine out of your blood, or in other words, reduce the blood concentration by half. Some drugs have really long half-lives. Oritavancin has a half-life of about 16 days, while some insulins have a half-life of 42 minutes. We'll be analyzing acetaminophen, or also known as the brand name Tylenol, which has a half-life of about 2 hours. We're using Tylenol because it's one of the most used drugs in the United States, and because of its availability and its use in a variety of medications. It is, sadly, pretty easy to overdose. About 56,000 emergency room visits a year are due to Tylenol overdose. A typical dose of Tylenol is 1 gram, or 1,000 milligrams, which is usually taken as 2 500 milligram pills. But since we are first focusing on IV administration, it will quickly be given directly into the bloodstream. A typical adult has about 5 liters of blood, so after all the medication is in the blood, concentration is 1,000 milligrams in 5 liters, or 200 milligrams per liter. Once administered, the body starts changing the Tylenol into other chemicals in the liver, and then the kidney starts taking those chemicals out of the blood. The more medicine there is in the body, the faster it is removed, at least up to a certain level. This is what gives rise to the half-life idea of medicine removal. If you have had calculus or differential equations, the language would be that the rate the medicine is removed from the body is proportional to the amount of medicine and could be written this way. In other words, the derivative of the blood concentration is proportional to the blood concentration. And you may remember that it is an exponential function that has this property. Assuming that the IV is instantaneous, which it isn't, but it does simplify the model, and it is still pretty accurate, then at time equals zero, the concentration is 200 milligrams per liter. Since the half-life is 2 hours, in 2 hours we would have half as much, so 100 milligrams per liter. In 2 more hours, it would be 50 milligrams per liter, etc. But patients can be administered another dose in as little as 4 hours, although 6 is more common. But let's see what happens when a second dose is administered at 4 hours. The blood concentration won't be the same as the first dose, since there is already some Tylenol still in the body from the first dose. We will put the second dose in another column and line it up at the same time as the first dose. We can do the same calculation with this column as the first. Half of this dose will be eliminated in 2 hours, and half of what is left from the first dose will be removed. So after the second dose, there's about 250 milligrams per liter concentration. 2 hours after the second dose, it's 125. Then 4 hours later, another dose can be administered. We do the process again and see that after the third dose, we have an even higher concentration, 262.5. So here is a very serious issue. If someone keeps taking Tylenol every 4 hours, would the concentration in the body approach toxic levels? It will keep increasing according to our model, so you may be wondering, how could the blood concentration not reach toxic levels if it increases with each dose? Well, in mathematics, there is a pretty crazy phenomenon. Suppose you have a value, say 1, and you add a smaller value, say a half, and you add to those an even smaller number, and a smaller number, etc. If you do this infinitely many times, will the sum be finite or infinite? Intuition might tell you infinite, but mathematics tells us it actually depends. Some sums of decreasing positive numbers like this one do sum to infinity, but others, like this one, actually sum to a finite value, in this case, 2. This diagram actually makes it really easy to see how this infinite series could sum to a finite value. So is the blood concentration more like the infinite series that goes to infinity, or the one that levels out to a finite value? And if it levels out, will it level out at a safe level? Before we answer this question, a solemn warning. There is a maximum amount of Tylenol any person should consume within 24 hours, and taking it more than 15 days a month can cause adverse effects. So even though we're using 4 hours between doses indefinitely, that is not sustainable. We're doing the math with Tylenol to see what happens with medications in general, even those that are prescribed to be taken indefinitely. A lot of pill bottles for acetaminophen will actually say no more than 3,000 milligrams a day, because there are so many other medications that have acetaminophen in them that it is easy to accidentally overdose, if taking 4,000 milligrams in tablets and then taking other medications, like NyQuil or Sudafed or painkillers like oxycodone. So please be careful. Let's see what happens in this worst case scenario of 4 hours between dosages. As we look at the values, there seems to be a pattern. It starts with 200, and then adds a quarter of 200, then a 16th of 200, etc. Since each dose is being reduced by a factor of 1/4 every time there is a new dose. This series is a special kind of series called a geometric series. Each number is a constant multiple of the number before it. In this case, that multiple is 1/4. This is one of the special cases where we can find the sum of an infinite series using a formula. This formula works anytime the multiple is between a negative 1 and 1. In all other cases, the sum of a geometric series is not finite. Using this formula, our sum is 266.66 grams per liter. This means that according to our model, the concentration would level out to this number. And this gives doctors confidence that blood concentrations will not become toxic in patients that are on a medication indefinitely. So if this is below toxic levels, then there won't be an issue. Although for Tylenol and other medications, the total amount your body processes is a bigger issue than the blood concentration. Although using half-life is often a good model to accurately model what happens with the drug, our values are off because we are assuming all the medicine stays in the blood. In reality, the medicine travels to other organs, so when doctors actually test the blood concentration, it is much less than 200 grams per liter. In practice, Tylenol concentrations are usually reported as micrograms per milliliter, which is what we use in our next example. To more accurately model both the medicine entering and leaving the blood, we can use technology to help us out, and graph subsequent doses of the pills, not just IVs. We can use the idea of function transformations to make this easy. This is a function that approximates the blood concentration of Tylenol after taking 1,000 milligrams in pill form. After 4 hours, the blood concentration will be the new function, shifted over 4 hours, and then added to the amount in the blood from the previous dose. We can represent that as f of t minus 4 plus f of t. Then the next dose we can create by graphing f of t minus 8 plus f of t minus 4 plus f of t, and keep on going. Notice the peaks seem to get higher and higher, but seem to be leveling out. We might be able to use our tools from a geometric series to be more confident in this claim. I've listed the 5 peak values from our curves in GeoGebra, and I found the differences, which was what we looked at in the previous model with half-lives. Are these values approximately geometric? If they are, then the common ratio between each value should be the same. Unfortunately, they are not. But the ratios keep going down, so a geometric series would be an overestimate. So we could find an upper bound by assuming each value is found by multiplying this first ratio, which is the largest, and using our formula for the sum of the geometric series. This gives us a result less than 19, which is still less than the therapeutic levels, not even close to toxic levels, of 150 micrograms per milliliter. The risk, then, is not the toxic levels in the blood, it is just the total amount your liver has to metabolize that could cause serious issues. I tried the same analysis with someone taking pills every 30 minutes, and the peaks quickly grew and were well on their way to toxic levels. please be careful with your medications. Keep them out of the reach of children and always follow the instructions that come with the medications. Maybe we can help eliminate the nearly 100,000 accidental overdose deaths that happen every year. And that number is just for the United States. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe and share our videos. Be sure to follow Math the World on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook. Thank you so much for your support.